Hello world, Mr. Resistor here, continuing our alpha journey, and I had been planning on doing some faction warfare today, but still not feeling well, so I don't think I'm gonna do that, but I will do some missions, and I guess some mining. Judging by the numbers, this probably isn't going to give me 25 kills. We'll see. Some drone sites here. Maybe let's try to hit them first.
Warp drive active.
Let's hit up the other one.
Warp drive active.
Alright. Well, not the loot I was looking for. But I did get kills, so it's all good.
Warp drive active.
Maybe I was wrong. Maybe it will give me the kills I'm looking for.
A module has run out of charges.
They collected everything. Kinda zoned out there for a minute. Alright.
Warp drive active. Permission requested. Docking request accepted.
Good. All right. Back to Ulbra.
Warp drive active. Docking permission requested. Docking request accepted.
Go get ourselves some Scordite.
Warp drive active.
Well, I've got a minute. Just go through and make sure I'm not missing anything. So, yeah, I know I haven't stated it in a while, but it's come up a couple of times in comments of what exactly is my goal here. And, well, I guess the real answer is that's a good question. So, broadly speaking, my goal is to show EVE Online the real experience of it as a casual player. You know, that's not putting any money into it, right? Because I've got nephews who don't have income of their own and whose parents are not going to pay for, you know, a subscription for them. So, you know, I guess to some extent that's my target audience. So there's questions of why haven't I gone Omega yet? And the real answer is that requires more dedication than I'm maybe willing to put into this account. EVE Online has a reputation of becoming sort of like a second job. And I've never felt that way about it. You know, I don't mention offhand, but, you know, I do have actually 6 other characters on 4 other accounts, all of which are Omega, and I pay for those because I do have an income. And a good enough income that I don't, you know, paying for 4 EVE Online subscriptions is not a huge deal for me. So, you know, I'm fortunate in that respect. You know, and I think the game is worth paying for me. But, you know, I do think that maybe it does need fresh blood. you know, and not necessarily people who are paying for the game, although, you know, certainly I would like for CCP to continue to be profitable and to continue to support the game, but, you know, just having more people playing is worth something, right? And so, you know, that's kind of who this is for. People who are like, well, what's the game like? Is this something that I'm going to be interested in? They can watch this channel and see what it's about, right? What it's going to be like. That's why I don't edit, because, you know, in order to support that goal, it's important to show everything, even the boring parts. And, you know, I do talk about going Omega sometimes. It is something that I might do on this character at some point. I've certainly talked about it. It's not a current goal. The current goal is just maxing out skill points, basically. And, you know, it's, and maybe that's a bad goal.
because I'm not, you know, the skills that I have left are not ones that I care about, right? They're for weapon systems that I don't use much, you know, for ships that I'm unlikely to fly anytime soon. I mean, maybe I'll fly some pirate ships, so it's worth having, like, the, you know, other Empire training, but... But as it is now, I'm happy with what Minmatar has to offer. And, you know, basically between Minmatar and Orr, I'm good as far as what I want from the game. So, you know, maybe I should be working more towards earning the ISK needed to Plex. I believe I mentioned last time, somebody mentioned joining in one of the larger alliances and, you know, making use of the free ships, making use of the ability to rat in NullSec to earn the ISK to Plex. And that is a good suggestion. I always kind of shied away from those big alliances. For a variety of reasons, but, you know, I'm not super into PvP is one of the big ones, and so I really see the attraction of it. But, man, pardon my coughing breaks. I'm certainly not saying that other people shouldn't do that. In fact, you know, if you have any interest in doing that, you should. And even if you don't have a lot of interest in it, maybe you should anyway, because at least having some experience is good. One of the things that I think it was actually helpful to me as a player going through, you know, doing faction warfare, trying to get through all of the air, what's it called? Air career program. The air career program tasks, right? And especially the one where you have to lose, was it 20 ships, 25 ships? I think completing that was actually really good for me as a player. It helped, you know, just get me used to the idea that losing a ship isn't that big a deal. And also to sort of plan accordingly, you know, if you're flying a slasher that, you know, the total fit's worth barely over a million ISK, you know, who cares if you lose it, right? Like, I mean, it always sucks to lose a ship. You never want to lose a ship, but it's not a big deal, you know? And just kind of getting over that mental hurdle was good for me. And I think, you know, maybe joining one of those big alliances and participating in their battles and training and whatever is probably good for a new EVE player. Or an old EVE player. Like I said, was good for me, I think. So, I think, you know, but I have done some PvP. You know, I'm not a total stranger to it. I've done enough to know that I'm not great at it. Possibly I'd be a decent Logi pilot, you know, so maybe that would be a good you know, or electronic warfare perhaps. You know, maybe those would be the more support or utility roles might be the better place for me if I was going to join into you know, a big alliance or something. But yeah, it's you know, but I also, you know, I like having my own schedule, being my own boss sort of thing, you know. And you know, and I do okay. I make enough ISK through my activities and, you know, mine enough ore that I'm able to build the things that I want to build. Not quickly, but I get there. And I enjoy sort of building up those supply chains on my own, and I don't mind that it takes time to do that. So yeah, that's kind of, but again, those are my personal choices in the game, and I'm certainly not advocating that everybody should play the way that I play, right? There's a lot of different ways to play Eve, and I would say the only ways to play that are wrong are the ways that are sort of wrong in any game, which is basically griefing, you know. Which certainly, I think, you know, Eve maybe allows a little more. It's a little bit more a part of the gameplay, and you know, and some people argue that that's core to the Eve experience. I don't know that I have a good counter argument, other than that, you know, it's not something that I enjoy. So, anyway, that's enough of me rambling, I think.
Warp drive active.
I feel like I kind of lost my point. Oh yeah, plexing. Maybe that should be more my direct goal at this point, because, you know, the accumulation of skill points is going to happen.
Docking permission and, requested. Docking request accepted.
The main problem is my plan for flexing is to do faction warfare LP conversion. Doing faction warfare requires time that I haven't had recently. So, if it feels like this channel is kind of on a plateau, it's not just you. I feel that way also. And I'm thinking about what to do about it. Well, anyway, that's going to be it for me for today. So until next time, have a good one.